electromotive force. Okay, in this motional electromotive force, what is actually the concept means here? Let us suppose that a conductor material, electromotive force, whenever general EMF is different here, motional electromotive force means here the concept I want to convey is that let me explain with the situation here. That is, consider a straight conductor of moving in uniform independent magnetic field, that is a time independent. So consider a straight moving time independent means a time varying, okay, it doesn't depends on time. Consider a straight conductor. So let me draw the diagram over here to make you understand. First of all, see, this is actually the magnetic field, the cross mark you are observing over here, no, those are magnetic field. We are taking perpendicular magnetic field. So in this perpendicular magnetic field, I have taken, this is the that is a rectangular chamber of that is the production of electric field, of course. Okay, so here this is the conductor, the PQ is the conductor I have taken here. Yes, are you following? The PQ is the conductor here. In this conductor, what I am observing in this field, a rectangular conductor, that is here this is a rectangular conductor, PQ is the conductor, okay, and in this rectangular conductor, yes, in which the conductor PQ, this conductor in this rectangular box, this conductor is free to move towards left or right, left or right, it can move over within the chamber of a rectangular chamber. Now, what I want to convey is that what is the concept of motional electromotive force here? The motional electromotive force leads you that, see, let us suppose that the PQ, this rod is moving. Let us suppose that this is moving in a negative direction. When this is moving in a negative direction, that is moving towards left. The length of a rod which is moving towards here left, that is in a negative sense. Let us suppose that axis wide, if you speak axis wide, this would be negative direction, right? So it is moving. Let us suppose that whenever this PQ rod is moving like this, can you imagine always the PQ RS is the same area? Of course no. Why? Because while it is while PQ rod is moving towards left, then area will decreases. It is, let us suppose that here the rod PQ, that is the rod is a conductor. Okay, I have taken, this is the magnetic field, time varying magnetic field here. Time varying in the sense time independent magnetic field. So time independent magnetic means varying magnetic field. I have considered a rod here. This rod is moving towards left. Is it clear to you? So whenever it is moving towards left, why we are making it to move? We are finding the momentary electromotive force. Actually, it is developing whenever it is moving in a magnetic field. A conductor definitely gives the electromotive force only, but we are studying the motional electromotive force I want to discuss. So for that, what I am doing here, this PQ is, whenever it is moving, let us suppose that it is moving with velocity V. Okay. Now, what is going on here? Assume that there is no loss in the energy due to friction. Actually, whenever it is moving in the shape, just don't think that, assume that there is no friction. Okay. The frictionless it is going on. Then we can estimate what is going on here. So PQRS form a closed circuit. Actually, PQRS forms a closed circuit, no? Yeah, closed circuit enclosing that area changes. Actually, whenever PQ is moving, the area will changes. That will be decreases. Area will be decreases, right? This is a scenario to understand the motional electromotive force. What is actually the definition point of view? Let me explain you. Okay, so yeah, it is placed in a uniform magnetic field B when it is perpendicular to the plane of the system, right? Yeah, I have given in the diagram, if the length of RQ is equal, that is QR is equal to X and RS is equal to L, then what happens? According to actually our law, the Faraday's, in the magnetic flux, let us suppose that d pi is enclosed by the loop, then PQRS will, what happens? The number of lines, the magnetic flux would be the magnetic, produced magnetic field within the area. That is actually the law, right? So B, Lx is the area. Yes, Lx is the area, and where B is the magnetic field within the chamber. Okay, now, since X is changing with the time, the rate of change of flux, the changing, it is changing with the time, I said, no? So it is, time is not constant. So time varying field, I said. So while it is time varying field, so since it is a time varying field, actually what happens here, we are taking B alone. Yes, when B is alone changing, that is pi is equal to A cos, that is dB by dt. Let us suppose that whenever you are taking B alone, and then equation would be A cos theta dB by dt. Then A is alone, then the equation would be changes, that is B cos theta dA by dt. That is actually here where dx by dt means, I said that the rod PQ is moving with velocity. No, so velocity means dx by dt. That is in a negative direction it is moving. So I want to take minus V, so which is the speed of a conductor PQ. Now what is my motto? The motional EMF, what actually the motional EMF? The induced EMF is called, what actually the induced EMF? See here, are you observing? Induced EMF is called whatever the electromotive force is within the cross-sectional area, within the prescribed area, within the prescribed area. That is the induced EMF within the area due to movement of the rod, due to movement of the conductor. Are you following? The induced EMF within the prescribed area, induced EMF within the prescribed area, prescribed area, that is by moving of a conductor. That is actually the motional EMF. Okay, so the motional EMF, see again, how we have to find out the direction of motional EMF in the circuit, using our right hand rule, Fleming right hand rule. The direction, see, let us suppose that if the direction of velocity of conductor in this direction here, if you place your right hand, if the thumb side, if you saw direction of velocity of a conductor, this would be perpendicular to this. This would be what? This would be magnetic field. We are taking actually like this. Okay, in the diagram which we have observed, previous diagram, the magnetic field, here the direction of this magnetic field, then we have the again induced current would be the what? Perpendicular to it again, like left hand rule. Sorry, right hand rule. Fleming right hand rule. Motional EMF we can take using, we can find the direction of motional EMF using right hand rule concept. Okay, the direction of induced current obtained by the Fleming right hand rule. Where according to this actually right hand rule, what actually right hand rule conveying? Thus, if middle finger, forefinger and thumb of right hand are held mutually perpendicular, then what happens? Then the forefinger represents the direction of a magnetic field and the thumb represents the direction of velocity of a conductor, and middle finger represents the direction of induced current. This is actually what? Our motional EMF. Motional EMF means whenever a rod is moving in a particular time varying magnetic field, the how much the momentarily how much it is producing the induced EMF. Induced EMF produced by the momentary object. Induced EMF produced by the momentary object is the motional EMF. Okay, so yes, when a current carrying conductor when a conductor carries current is free to move in a magnetic field, the direction in which current will move in the direction is given by whenever you are reading Fleming, that is whenever you are studying immediately after the topic, then it would be very easy, but when after the completion of chapter, it would be a bit tough. That is the reason to please be concentrated. The direction of induced EMF determined by right hand rule. Okay, yes. Now energy consideration. I want to say energy consideration. Energy consideration means what? Consideration means energy. How the energy point? Where is the energy point? And what is the energy point? See, we are discussing the motional EMF. The motional EMF means what you are understanding, beta? Within the field, whenever a rod is moving, within the field, whenever due to the moment of the conductor within the field, you are calculating, that is induced EMF. So whenever it is, so by moving means what? What is going on here? With the movement, the induced EMF we are calculating. The induced EMF, the EMF, induced EMF, which is because of movement of the rod. Are you following? The induced EMF, movement of the rod means the mechanical energy which we are converting, which we are using as a electrical energy. Are you following? Here, what is the phenomenon is going on? In case of motional, whenever you are finding out the motional EMF, then you are observing the mechanical energy, you are observing induced current there. Within the area, you are observing induced current whenever it is moving. So, movement is nothing but mechanical. Movement is nothing but the mechanical energy. Then it is converted. We are taking output is a current. So, mechanical energy which is converted into electrical energy. This is actually energy consideration. Means how the energy is converting mechanical to electrical, and what energy, what is going on. And the energy consideration means in the relation between what, actually we will study. Okay, discuss energy consideration in case of electromotive, that is motional EMF, motional electromotive force. This is the question. Okay, discuss energy consideration. So what energy you are considering, that is the question. Okay, what type of energy you are considering? The energy consideration is mainly the mechanical energy, which is there is a electrical energy, conversion of electrical energy. So now let me discuss, let R be the resistance in a movable arm. That is movable arm means that is a rod. Okay, let us suppose that R is a resistance of a rod. Okay, so we assume that remaining arms, again now we are taking four chamber, no, rectangular chamber. So that chamber, let us suppose that remaining arms like electrical circuit. Okay, so on the remaining chamber we will take QR, RS, SP have somewhat negligible resistance, let us suppose that. Why? Because in order to determine the energy, that is how much the energy is producing, how much energy is dissipating over there, we are calculating. That is the reason we are taking like that that is remaining arms, the negligible resistance is there. Okay. Thus, the overall resistance of the rectangular loop, entire loop, we can take it as R. Why? Because remaining all is the negligible, where we are considering only the rod resistance. Okay. And this does not change as PQ is moved. Okay. Let us suppose that constant resistance. Okay. Yes, the current I in the loop. So, how you can calculate current in the loop? In the rectangular loop, how we can calculate the current? That is actually using our formula. That is minus d pi by t pi. That is the number of lines of force. How many magnetic lines of force are there? That much current would develop in that loop, no? Yes, that is d pi b by dt. That is d by dt of pi b. That is with respective, whenever we are taking with respective to that rod, then we can take one corner, that is the balancing, that is whenever here the B alone, only the B alone, only the A, like that we can take. Okay. So on account of this resistance of magnetic field, there will be a force on arm PQ. So the force, what we can say, that is a force which is nothing but I of L cross B. We can take I of L cross B, which is directed towards the direction of opposite velocity of the rod. Do you remember this? What is this, beta? Do you remember? The force, whenever the rod is moving left side, opposite side, there will be a production of, yeah, this is the force. Due to this force, there is a production of induced current there. Okay, production of induced current there. Actually, the magnitude of that entire force, what we can write here, that drift, the magnitude is nothing but that causes for the drift. Okay, the magnitude, we can say, that is only that when we are writing, that is along with only alone B, alone A, we are taking, no? The magnitude we can determine like that. The force arises due to actually here drift of charges actually. Why? Because whenever rod is moving, there is a drift of charges in the particular area which is preoccupied. Okay. Along the rod and the consequence of a Lorentz force acting on them. Of course, no? The Lorentz force acting on them. Okay. This is actually the Lorentz force acting on them. Okay. Yes. Alternatively, what is going on? And the arm PQ is being pushed with a constant speed. The power is required to do this absolutely. Without power, it only doesn't move, no? The power is required for that. That is, what is the power is acting over there? What the power is acting over there, the work done is acting over there, no? So what is that work done? Actually, we can take it as the flux, which is would be B A d cos theta by dt. That is the work done by the agent because of, what is that agent? The work done is because of what? Mechanical energy. Okay, the mechanical energy. Where does this mechanical energy go actually? Some mechanical work is going on, no? Due to that mechanical work, energy is producing, no? That energy, where it goes, energy? That's what the question in. Actually, it is dissipated in. Actually, what happens? Whenever it is moving, whenever the rod is moving in a field, what happens? It produces heat, no? It is dissipated as a joule heat, and it is given by, actually, this is given by ER, that is d pi by dt by R, charge by R. Then mechanical energy, which was expanded in moving the arm PQ, is converted to electrical energy, and then it would be a thermal energy. Are you following? Okay. Whenever mechanical energy is converting into electrical energy, after that, that is electrical energy is nothing but induced EMF, and it is turned into thermal energy. Okay, this is actually which whatever the this in make a motive EMF, that is the motional EMF everywhere in the instrument wherever we are using the mechanical energy which is converted into electrical energy. Okay, converse statement, can you say any example for where electrical energy is converting into mechanical energy? Can you give an example beta? Electrical energy which is converting into mechanical energy. Yes, yeah, fan, very good. In the fan we are using electrical energy is converting into mechanical energy, no? There is actually the function of we are using electrical energy, we are making into the work done which is output is the mechanical energy. Electrical energy we are giving mechanic. Here what I am saying, motive, the motional, that is reverse to that. I am explaining reverse to that, where the mechanical energy that is actually in the turbines. The example here is the turbines. Wherever you are rotating, then due to the rotation you are producing current, the mechanical energy which is converted into electrical energy. Okay, yes. What actually, see, this is an interesting relationship between, so yeah, what actually we have discussed here, whenever you are observing the conversion of mechanical energy into electrical energy, we can find there is a relation between within the actually the relation between electrical charge produced in the circuit and the magnetic flux. Actually we didn't supplied any direct, are you with me? We didn't supplied any direct charge there. We have given only magnetic field. Are you observing? Just are you thinking better? Just think, very, very interesting chapter. If you are thorough with the basics, then it will be very beautiful. Okay, you can extend your thoughts. What I am saying, we are giving magnetic field. In the magnetic field, I have considered magnetic field is there means time varying magnetic field is there means definitely there would be induction. That is what in our first class we have discussed in this chapter. Right? Is it right or not? What I am speaking, actually, wherever the electric field is there, there is a magnetic field. There is a production due to loops of current. After completion of a single loop, there would be starts the magnetic field. Okay, this is the scenario. Ekkada electric field unte akkada magnetic field, oka loop end avvagane magnetic field start avutundi. But converse statement lo em jarugutundi ante, whenever there is a magnetic field lines, magnetic flux lines, magnetic field lines, that is a varying magnetic field lines, there will be production of induced field. Direct magnetic field, due to magnetic field, there is no direct production of electric field. Try to understand the concept. Okay, there is a induced, that is called actually induced field. That is what we experimentally before the Faraday's law we have discussed. Okay, here using that time varying magnetic field, we are able to produce with the mechanical energy, we are able to produce electrical energy. This is the scenario which is going on in motional EMF. Okay, this is the scenario in motional EMF. So due to this, what actually we are doing, we are producing relation between current and the magnetic flux. How much the flux you are giving, that much electric field we can produce. Right or not? And one more thing is also there, the magnetic, how much the flux you are producing in a base point, that much electricity you can produce. Of course, one more base point is also there, how much the work done due to the rod is also a point. Right or not? Yes, think. Okay, so from Faraday. Faraday's law, we have learned that magnitude of, yeah, the Faraday's law explains what? The magnitude of induced EMF, which is equal to, that is magnitude of induced EMF, where EMF, which is equal to d pi by dt, right? D pi by dt, that is a flux, d by variation, d by dt of pi means what? Variation of electric lines of force will give you induced EMF. Okay, the magnitude, this is actually the Faraday's law, the relation. Okay, here what we are observing in this motive, motional EMF, the relation, but see, this is the magnitude of EMF, which is equal to, I will not write here, IR. So that is d pi by dt, which is equal to dq by dt, that is dq into R now. Yes, dq into R, then dt gets cancelled, what we will get? Hence dq is equal to d pi by r, dq is equal to d pi by r. So what is this relation, what you are understanding? So this relation is actually what? Q means what? Heat. Here the heat energy is producing due to the magnetic flux, the rate of magnetic flux due to the range, that is a separation, due to the separation, that due to the movement, due to the change of r. Change of R means what? Change of R means what? Movement, mechanical work done. Change of R means mechanical work done. That is dq is equal to d pi by R. This is the relation we will get from motional EMF energy consideration. Is it clear, beta? What we have discussed in today's class? Motional EMF, okay? That is motional EMF means the movement of a conductor within the magnetic field. Due to that movement, what is going on? Due to that movement, using induced field, we are creating again the field, current. Using induced field, we are creating current. This is the scenario. Okay, using magnetic induced means here, induced field means indirect meaning is that due to magnetic flux. Okay, this is actually the motional EMF energy consideration. Okay, the very, very interesting topic. Now, Faraday's law gives relation of magnitude of induced EMF is, what's the relation we can observe here? Tell me, I won't tell you. Tell me, please. I will skip the slide. You give me answer through the telegram by the evening. Okay, I will give here the, yeah, I just want to skip. Give an answer. Shift. Yeah, see, this is, yeah. What is this? Magnitude, dt by d pi. Into time varying, there R is also time varying. Here we are taking P, no issue, whatever it may be, both are the same, this and this, both are the same, no? Okay, this is directly the Faraday law. This is the relation of magnitude with induced EMF. Yes, energy consideration gives us the relationship between the charge flow through the circuit and the change in the where we are finding change, that is in yes, magnetic flux, change in magnetic flux over the charge flow within the circuit. Yes, now the next topic I will discuss you is that eddy currents. What are eddy currents? Have you listened this word earlier to this? Eddy currents. What are the eddy currents? See, till now we have discussed within the closed loop. Okay. Each and every topic is interconnected. Remember. Okay. If you don't connect like that, you will forget what we have discussed first. Motional EMF. That motional EMF, how the energy. So what type of energy is producing, what is going on there? Now my doubt is that in eddy currents, what are the eddy currents means? I will define you, but I will define But before going to that, within the closed chamber, we are observing the movement of the rod. Within the closed chamber, concentrate here. Within the closed chamber, we are observing movement of the rod. If in an open field, what happens? Let us see. Before going to eddy currents, we will see that. Yeah, open field. Yeah, I am giving open field here. This is the magnetic, that is the magnet, this indicates magnetic flux better. That is magnetic field, magnetic lines of force, this is a field. If flux is changed in a closed circuit, a current induced in it, of course. Okay? Yes. If instead of a closed circuit, a metal plate or a disc either made to vibrate in a magnetic field or placed in a variable magnetic field. Let us suppose that variable magnetic field we have placed. Okay. So then induced currents are set up in according to Joule's law. This is what we discussed just now. Okay. So induced currents develops. Okay. This is a rod, beta. This is a rod. Okay, and keep on moving like this, using some pivot point. Are you understanding what I am saying? In previous slide, that is the previous discussion, I have placed a rod here. I am moving like this for our understanding. Now what I am doing, for a pivot point, I am fixing a rod, same here. I am fixing a rod, but here there is no particular area. I am fixing a rod and I am moving this like this. Like oscillations. Yes, due to that what happens, of course, the heat generates there, right? Yeah, the heat energy generates due to the mechanical energy. What happens? Heat energy generates. Due to that, whatever we have considered, the plate or disc, metal plate or disc, whatever it may be, that would get heated. That would get heated. So then what happens? A flat conducting plate of aluminium or copper is oscillated through a magnetic field B acting perpendicular to the plane of a paper and then directed inwards like as the shown in figure just now. The direction of eddy currents, actually eddy current, let me explain eddy current definition. So just direction of eddy currents are such that they are compensating increasing in flux. Whatever the lines of force is there, are you understanding? Whatever the lines of force, that is the magnetic lines of force are there. Whenever you are hanged from a pivot point, whenever you have taken a rod, then it is moving, like making oscillations, let us suppose that. Whenever it is making the oscillations, then what happens? There is a induced EMF, that is a heat energy produced means induced EMF, that is a motional EMF develops there. Okay, due to development of motion, EMF, due to development of EMF, motional EMF, that is, that can increase the flux, no? That is only d by dt of pi we are writing, no? So, the increment in the flux, that is actually the form of Allen's law. Okay. So, accordingly, when metal plate enters into the field, the direction of eddy currents are counterclockwise. Let us suppose that whenever you are inserting a metal plate, whatever the current is producing, it is to counterclockwise to the eddy current. That is the whatever the current produced there, that is the clockwise. When leaving the field, it is the direction will be clockwise, counterclock, anti-clock and clockwise, leaving and adding. So now let me explain you eddy currents. What are, as the conducting plate enters the field, the eddy currents are counterclockwise. Okay, conducting plate enters. See, this is the pivot point. Okay, this is the rod. Okay, so while it is entering, means it is, see, it is entering into the field. While it is entering, the currents are in counterclockwise, means anti-clockwise. The currents are in anti-clockwise, like this. Currents are in, as the plate. So, now, as a plate leaves the field, means here it is leaving the field, after coming here leaving the field, again it starts. Okay, as the plate leaves the field, currents are in clockwise. Okay, yeah. In either the case, the force of a plate is opposite to the velocity, and eventually the plate comes to rest, of course. Okay, these induced currents, whatever the induced currents are there, no, those are called eddy currents. Okay, the induced currents means due to mechanical energy the current is producing, that is induced current. Okay, yeah, due to induced field, so that current is the induced current, that due to that induced current, whenever it is showing the direction, that is means whenever clockwise and anti-clockwise we are discussing, that induction is coming out, right? Yeah, that induced current is called actually eddy current. Eddy current means due to what you can, how you can answer, what are eddy currents? The eddy currents are the resultant of motional electric field, that is the motional EMF. Okay, motional EMF, that is the within the energy consideration of a motional EMF, the results are the resultant induced current is the eddy current. Are you following? within the motional EMF energy consideration, the induced currents are known as eddy currents or Foucault currents. Okay, Foucault's currents, actually the scientist who has studied about this in 1895 is based on his name. Those are also called as the Foucault's currents, or eddy currents are well known. Okay, this is about eddy currents. Okay, the circulating currents is set up in a bulk pieces of a metal moving through a magnetic field are called currents. Of course, you can define like this: the circulating currents is set up in bulk pieces of metal moving through the magnetic field are called eddy currents. The simple definition. Okay, yes, where we can use these eddy currents? Now my doubt is that where we are using these eddy currents, can you say answers, your ideas, where actually we are using these eddy currents? We are studying, first of all, before going to this, you have to understand what are eddy currents. Ardham avutunda beta? Eddy currents ante enti? First enti? In the motional electromotive force, energy consideration lo produce ayye currents, vaatini manam ekkada use chestunnam, eddy currents. Literally we are in magnetic, ekkada nen cheptanu oka hint isthanu, meer cheppandi, magnetic field valla movement lo unna prati daggara dinni use chestam manam eddy currents. Ippudu cheppandi where we can use, actually the application point of view, damping effect. Okay, actually damping means what? Damping means the function, the phenomenon which is decreasing, which can decrease with time, the phenomenon which can decrease with time, that is damping. Taggi povadam, kaalantho paatu taggi pothe dan em antam, dan em antam, damping effect antam. So the damping effect of eddy currents has been put used in the following. Damping effect ni baga use chestam enduku? In a single field, the application, see how beautiful application, what is the actually the scenario? In single field, it is while it is entering clockwise, while it is in like a switch, no, are you observing like a switch? No, we are using switch, we are using electrical switch. While start we are pressing, to get it on we are pressing, to get it off we are again pressing, means we are using two functions in a single switch. The same eddy currents topic in a damping effect. Damping effect means, that is the reason I explained to you, while it is entering, what happens? It is in counterclockwise. While it is again leaving, it is in clockwise. So the two functions we are observing in a single frame. Yes, you have to think like that. Okay, so the damping scenario we are using for our, yes, first one in brakes, magnetic brakes. Okay, magnetic breakage lo baga use chestundi. Okay, the second one, deadbeat galvanometer means in a that is the zero arrangement of a galvanometer, that is induction of a furnace to create the big furnaces are there, no, to extract metals, the big furnace, the flame furnace will be there, no, in that also we can use eddy currents. Okay, the first application is magnetic brake, second is a deadbeat galvanometer, induction furnace. These three are the applications of eddy currents. Okay, the first, let us see magnetic brake, how the brake can takes place. Yeah, let me draw the diagram. Yeah, whenever a magnetic train is moving, it axle rotates, no, when train is moving. So when train is moving, it axle rotates continuously. A drum attached with its axle also rotates. Whatever the drum attached, that is rotates like this, no, drum. To stop the train, what we have to do? The magnetic field is applied on the rotating drum. To stop magnetic trains, what we have to do? The field we have to apply on the train. Whenever you are applying field on the train, let me give the diagram. See, this is the drum. So what happens here? Whenever you are applying the magnetic field in this drum, these are rotating, no? The wheels are rotating around it, no? When you are, same, imagine our previous diagram on the sheet, when the rod is moving. Okay, so what happens here? When you are applying magnetic field on the drum, which is rotating while the train rotates. Okay, so due to what happens while entering, while exit, entering, leaving, current. So attraction, repulsion takes place. What happens here? Due to the attraction, what happens whenever you are applying magnetic field here? Due to the attraction, current develops there. That is the induced current develops there. Eddy current. This is the eddy current. Eddy current, whatever the current develops, which is in, see, the direction I am showing you. Whenever both are in same direction, then what happens? There is no movement. Again, here, see, for this field, whenever this is in case of a repulsion, the eddy current direction is again parallel. Again perpendicular to the field. Okay, again, field, no? So, due to that, what happens? These are actually the parallel fields. Are you observing? These are the parallel fields. Okay, this is in the direction and these two are the parallel fields. And both can create the negative eddy currents here. Okay, eddy currents here. Due to that, what happens? These two are mutually parallel to each other. Whatever is producing in case of attraction or repulsion. Due to that, what happens? What happens? Train will stop. That is a brake. Okay? Breakage of a, applying breakage of a trains. Moving to eddy currents set up in the drum and opposite couple acts on it. Okay? As a result of that, that is train will stop. Okay? This system is called actually magnetic brake. Since eddy currents decreases steadily in magnitude as the train slows down, the braking effect is quite smooth. If you brake the train won't get stuck. Not like that. Gradually it will decrease. That is the reason we are using magnetic, in magnetic trains we are using eddy currents. That is the reason whenever you are press the brake, the train won't stop suddenly, like at a moment it will take slow down. Okay, whenever reaching the station, the train will be slow down. No, that is actually the due to the effect of eddy currents. Okay, yes. Now, deadbeat galvanometer. The deadbeat galvanometer, see, the coils of moving coil galvanometer, ammeter and voltmeter are wound over the metal frame. That is only the inner structure. So that due to eddy currents, the motion of these coils will be damped. These coils will be damped. So that the process is called actually EM damping. We can say EM damping, but the ballistic galvanometer, to reduce damping, the frames are made up of bad conductor like paper or bamboo. We have to insert. In your labs, you do one thing. If the galvanometer is not working, non-working galvanometer, I'm telling you, non-working galvanometer, if any you find, just open that. Don't open working galvanometer. Okay, non-working galvanometer, you open and see. Then actually there is a conductor would be introduced in between that coils, the wounded coils. Conductor, why? Because due to the, to avoid eddy currents. Okay, yes. Yes, next, induction furnace. Induction furnace means if the resistance of a conductor is very small, actually, then the resistance is whatever the conductor we are using, no, emotional EMF. If resistance is very small, means what? The high conductor, like silver. Silver is a good conductor, no? Perfect conductor. So if you use silver-like material, then in very strong, actually, these currents produces lot of heat. If you use good conductor, the lot of heat can be generated in that. Okay, and induction, let us suppose that if you take induction furnace, any furnace, it is based on principle of actually preparing alloys by melting all the constituent metals. They can consider furnace means what? Have you seen the diagram of furnace? Let me show the diagram. All the material, constituent materials, can be made into throwing in that high temperature. They are heated in high temperature. That is actually the furnace. In the all alloys we can observe it. So whenever they are throwing in furnace, then what happens? Then if you use the perfect conductor there, what actually there is a strong, very strong, very strong current will develops, right? Due to that amount of heat, due to eddy currents, is directly proportional to square of the frequency. Okay, the currents of high furnace are used in this, means whenever you are using in the furnaces, whenever they are using the perfect conductors, then production of these currents are very high. That is due to eddy currents only. Okay, why? Because here the eddy currents produced due to the heat produced due to eddy currents. How much the heat is more, that is very useful in furnace. No, in applications of what I want to say is that in applications, heat applications, that is a heat application, so we can use eddy currents effectively using perfect conductors. Okay, yeah, this is a furnace. See, this is a furnace where we can use here in order to in order to provide heat, they can arrange. Why? Because this furnace, these flames, whatever we are seeing, no, that is not due to current. That is due to the magnetic field. The magnets, they can arrange. Due to that, actually the lodestones also we can observe here. Okay, due to that heavy magnets, then the currents will develop. Using that current, here heat will be generated. Okay, this is the scenario in case of this furnace. Okay, yes, this is about actually eddy currents and their applications. Okay, with this we can complete this chapter, and if any topics are left, let me discuss. Okay, actually this is the eddy currents is the 4 marks question, main IPE point of view. Please be concentrate. Let me check if any topics are there. Okay, yes, stay tuned to the webinar, and please follow and submit the homework. Okay, the circulating currents are set up in bulk process of metal moving through a magnetic field are called what? Through magnetic field are called eddy currents. This is the definition of eddy currents. Okay, yes, this is the chapter where we have discussed EMI, electromagnetic induction. Okay, yes, have a great day.